We're just heading off to the south of Punjab today. It's about 2:30 in the morning. We've just had suhoor as well at a road cafe as well. Alhamdulillah, there's about 5 or 6 volunteers of Minhaj Welfare Foundation already in this auto bus as well. Hopefully we'll be received in a place called Karor Lal Isan. This is in the district Leya, where our volunteers are there. They've already established relief camps and already commenced in distributing relief aid to many hundreds of people in Karor Lal Isan as well. The team is going to get ready to go to an area affected in Karor Lal Isan, where we are going to see the situation and how severe the flooding has hit this part of the region in Pakistan as well. We're going to take the motorbikes because it's very hard for us to get to the flooded area because of the rise of the water. For the people in Karor Lal Isan, we're very unprepared, but alhamdulillah, the volunteers of Minhaj Welfare Foundation gathered at least 50 volunteers to help those that were affected by the flood as well. So an excellent effort from the volunteers of Minhaj Welfare Foundation. Everything has been destroyed. Crops have been destroyed, plantation has been destroyed as well. And if you look at the actual lake area, you can see everything has destroyed as well. The level of water, I've been told, was reached up to about 17 feet.
इतना सा कुछ ठीक है सन 20 साल आए
20 साल हो गए ने थे
मेहनत मजदूरी
20 साल की कमाई यही थी जो इधर बस जड़ गई
We just come to one of Minhaj Welfare Foundation's relief camp here at Karor Lal Isan, the district of Leya as well, where people are gathered up to collect rations, essentials for food necessities, food, water, medical facilities. We're distributing aid to the people as well. People are coming, there's essentials as lentils, there's milk as well, there's dates, there's sugar, there's flour as well, and there's also rice here distributed to the people as well. I'm standing on the middle of the road and already the water has increased. We have only entered Muzaffargarh. We've not even entered the city itself properly as well. And already the water from the actual Darya is coming onto the road.
जो आवाम पीछे है ना वो बहुत ज्यादा परेशान है बहुत ज्यादा
अच्छा
क्योंकि वो बड़े बड़े लोग हैं वो
कितने लोग हैं तकरीबन
कम से कम यहां 6-7000 लोग हैं
We're in Muzaffargarh, where there is going to be a distribution of food, water and medical supplies to people affected by the disaster. Muzaffargarh has been hit a couple of times now, 3 or 4 times. You can see on the side people waiting for food as well. Okay, what's going to happen is now they're going to start distributing the food. I'm just going to go inside into this very busy area as well.
پچیس لاکھ افراد سے زیادہ کی آبادی پر مشتمل ہے اس میں تقریباً مور دین 80% علاقہ زیر آب ہے بلکہ 90% علاقہ آپ کہیں کہ کیونکہ چند شہری علاقے صرف محفوظ ہیں باقی تمام ضلع جو ہے نا زیر آب آ چکے ہیں لوگوں کے گھر ملیا میٹ ہو چکے ہیں ان کی رہائش گاہیں ختم ہو چکی ہیں لوگ ٹبوں پر ان پہ جو علاقے بچ چکے ہیں ٹیلوں پر اور یہ جو مقصد علاقے کچھ اونچے ہیں جب وہاں پر بیٹھے ہوئے ہیں
Right, we're in Basira this present moment of time. We can see that the water has risen so much, it's impossible for cars to get on the other side. جیسے آپ کا نام کیا ہے؟
ملازم حسین
ملازم حسین آپ کہاں سے ہیں؟
یہ دیہات میں
اچھا آپ کا گھر بھی ختم؟
ختم ہو گیا سب کی
تو پھر ابھی کہاں جانے ہیں آپ؟
اب گھر جا رہے ہیں ادھر مال مویشی کا پتہ کرنے
The water is rising day by day as well, and there is a fear of cholera diseases. Even there is a problem with snake. This is a big problem here, that they're saying that snake, poisonous snakes are spreading within the water as well. Diseases are widespread as well. Cholera, other waterborne diseases are widespread as well. There is nothing done to support people to prevent waterborne diseases.
कुछ एरिया हमारा बचा हुआ है वहां पे किराए का मकान लिया हुआ है जिसके बच्चे बैठाएंगे
अच्छा अच्छा अभी आपके रिश्तेदार वहां बच्चे के साथ या अकेले रह रहे हैं वहां
कहां यहां पे
मुल्तान में
मुल्तान रिश्तेदार थे वहां पूछा
है अच्छा अच्छा और अभी आप बच्चे के साथ जा रहे हैं और
वापस जा रहे हैं
और यहां सब कुछ खत्म आपके लिए
हम सब अब नया शिफ्ट शुरू करेंगे
This is a very sincere individual as well. He said, whatever is provided to me, I'll just take that as well. Unfortunately, not many people are in this situation as well. Some people have just lost everything. At least he's got a house in Multan that he's rented, where he sent some of his children already. Some people don't have no one at all. They're still waiting for loved ones. They're still waiting for their children. They're still waiting for their parents. They're still missing and they're still looking for them here in this disaster as well. So it's a big struggle. And realistically, we don't know what's happening at this present moment of time. There's a lot of things being moved around from here to there, and a lot of people are moving without their own family members being with them as well. So it's a long road ahead for a lot of people here in this area of the world, in Pakistan, in Basira particularly as well. And we've heard that in other areas they've been affected and they've come here as well. They're going to Multana as well. So we'll see what will happen when they move to Multan or when they move to their areas, whether or not they'll be able to find their families or whether they'll be able to find some sort of sanctity as well.
गुज़िश्ता 20 दिनों से मुख्तलिफ पॉइंट्स पर हमने रिलीफ कैंप मुनक्किद किए हुए हैं मरकजी कैंप यही है जो पूरे जिले को कोऑर्डिनेट करता है अब तक इस जिले के तहत कमोबेश हम 5000 अफराद को खाना खिला रहे हैं सुबह दोपहर शाम का सुबह बच्चों को नाश्ता देते हैं बड़ों को नाश्ता देते हैं दो वक्त का खाना भी देते हैं और मुख्तलिफ पॉइंट्स पर हम मेडिकल कैंप्स वगैरह भी लगा रहे हैं जो मेन हमारे कैंप्स हैं जिसके तहत हम हज़ारों अफराद की अब तक हम हेल्प कर चुके हैं वो रोजान का कैंप है कोट मिठन शरीफ का कैंप है कोटला नसीर का कैंप है और ज़िले हेडक्वार्टर का ये कैंप
We've come here to the relief camp in Kotla Nasir, where there are 2,500 people establishing the relief camp. Behind me, you see the ambulance that's going to provide the victims here with medical aid. What we have here are some children who are part of the relief camp as well. They basically have nothing left as well. You can see the state of children here as well. There's no clothes at all. I'm presuming they've been wearing the same clothing for the past 20 days since they've been here in the camp as well. And they literally are in a very dire situation as well. And they are with their families. Some are orphans. Rajanpur is a population of, they're telling me about 18 lakh people. Now that's a lot of people. Now these area, Rajanpur, is divided into three main areas. You've got Rajanpur, Jampur, you've got Kot Mithin and Kotla Nasir. Kotla Nasir is where Minhaj Welfare Foundation has got a relief camp here as well.
सारे बर्बाद ही थी कुछ शायद नहीं रहा
था मुकम्मल घर जो है ना इनके तबाह हो गए
हैं ये लड़ गई हैं असर चला गया इतनी कपड़ा चाहिए बेटा
What's happened here in the actual relief camp is a lot of people have lost their lives as well. This auntie, she's lost everything. She's been here in the relief camp for more than 4 days now. The only thing she's got is her own clothing as well. Children crying. There's little children gathered here, innocent children. They've got nothing to wear, and this child has got no clothes. They've been here since the past 21 days. आपका नाम क्या है?
मोहम्मद जवेद.
जो आपके भाई कितने हैं?
पांच.
और बहनें?
अब्बा गुलाम यासीन है और फौत ठीक है.
His father's passed away. आपकी वालिदा है?
जी हां.
कहां है वो? सब कुछ इतने मिल रहे हैं आपको?
बाल डांडा काट गए मेरे बाल।
अच्छा
इतने सिर्फ मैं बैठी हूँ, मेरे बच्चे त्रे मेरी नौरियां
सही
पांच मेरे बच्चे
जी जी
अल्लाह
आपकी जजात It's really hard for this. This is the actual problem that this mother is feeling at the present moment of time. She's lost her husband. Her children, you can see here, just 10 years of age. And he's with his mother. It's the same clothing they tell me that he's been wearing since the past 21 days as well. And you know, when you see a mom cry like that, shed her tears, there are many mothers out there who have the opportunity to provide the children with everything. At this present moment of time, we're at the field where the relief camps have been established from Minhaj Welfare Foundation as well. Now, if you look at the state of the cattle, there are no state to provide them with livelihood as well. Just look at this, the cattle here as well. They've actually got no meat in them left, or they've got no energy left in them as well to provide the right source or resource for families. You see, families depend upon cattle to provide them some sort of nourishment or some sort of income. Now there's a couple of children here as well. They've had no clothing as well. This is the only clothing that they'll have left as well. Do you have any clothes?
No clothes.
They've lost their clothes as well. We should feel the pain that they are feeling at this present moment of time as well. This innocent child, he's got no clothes. They still are able to smile, even the situation that they are in as well. And if you take a deeper and closer insight to the deterioration of the skin as well, you can see the child, some of his skin is falling apart in the sense that illnesses are very common here as well. There's a great emphasis that these children have basically nothing. That is true, and that is the reality as well. Look at the state of the clothing here of the children as well. They've been wearing the same clothing for the past 15, 20 days as well. So everything has been destroyed. Houses have been destroyed. There's nothing left.